puddles here a little bit. I'm gonna take a round brush, clear water, get most of the water out of it. Circular motion, soften some of the edges. Like, it's repetition, I know, of what I said before.
It's good to say it again.
Yes, please.
And areas that I like, I'll keep. If I got little puddles like that, I'll just go like this and soak it right up.
And you're doing that with just clear water, right?
Yeah, just clear water. So, you see the nice softness you get that way?
Mm-hmm, that looks good.
You ever go into the cloud and soften inside?
Inside here?
Yeah.
Not very often. I usually try to leave the whites the first time, get in the water about the first time. Mm-hmm. And I can take that same color, or I can,
Yeah, when you're actually working on your own, do you talk yourself like that?
I know she's not talking to myself. Nancy would tell me if I did.
I just wonder. I mean, I have that kind of conversation.
Well, thank you. Yeah, okay. There's a little bit of permanent rose in there. See, just a hint. And also, just spice it up a little bit. I add just a touch of lemon yellow in here. You can hardly see it, but you see it, you know? The eye sees it. Just kind of warms it up a little bit. Nice. Can you see that at all?
Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm. Yeah.
So it's there, but it's not very strong. Make sure I'm down away from where the mountain needs to be here. So I want to make sure it washes out. So make sure if it's got a little tone in it, then when it dries, you're going to have a line right through. All right, so let's come in here and put that mountain in here. I drew a pencil line for the horizon, or the water line, I should say. I'm looking at, as soon as I land it in, I look at it and decide what I want to do here. I may decide to actually grab some of that sky color in there.
And that's a large round brush?
Yeah, just a large round brush. And I'm looking at it and thinking, okay, I'd like to have it a little darker at the top because I know it's going to dry light. Well, I'll just throw a little more pigment up here in the top, let it run down while it's all wet. And I'll do is I'll transition it with clear water now. I hit down here first. Because I want to maybe touch it and leave some white areas maybe. Actually, I'm going to fan it out like that. Now I'm going to grab my sap and some ultra. Need more sap. Actually, a little yellow. Dark enough. Sap. There we go.
Sap, ultramarine.
Yep.
Just those two?
Uh-huh. Dried on me, but that's okay. I come from this direction. Okay. And then just make sure it's clean. I'll take another swipe with clean water in there like that.
That blooms upwards.
Isn't that wonderful?
I love it.
And it could be a little darker, so I'll just put a little darker in the bottom. I'm going to sweep across fast because I want some of this dry brush effect in here. So in a horizontal, see the whole arm, using brick from the shoulder. I'm going to come in here like this.
That's horizon blue?
Yeah, it's got a little ultra and a little fade in it. It's ultramarine blue and sap green majority. Some brushes come out better than others. The key is you gotta get the water out of them. That's right, I'm gonna put my mop brush. This four is a great mop brush for this kind of thing.
But you took my mop brush back?
I didn't take anything off your table. Everybody takes stuff off my table though.
Well, yeah.
Oh, I noticed paper missing too. Yeah. So, all right, let's put these trees in here. Starts about, it's dry so I can put my hands on it. Don't panic if you run out of paint. Just go back over that same stroke.
Umber and
paints? Uh-huh.
Yep.
There's a smaller one in there. So, I got it fanned out.
Ultra sap and
took years.
We're going to go over here.
To figure that out.
save yours.
Really, it's funny, isn't it?